Hello, everybody, and welcome back to WCW My Universe playthrough, WWE2k20. And this is supposed to be our episode of WCW Greed. But there won't be a full video because I majorly screwed up. So, earlier tonight, it's... Let's see what day it is today. It is Saturday, April 27th. Well, now, as a recording of this, it's the next day, just after midnight. But I was getting prepared to record Greed, the playthrough of it. I got all the matches set up, all the stipulations, matches I wanted. And I was on the screen to start the show. And instead of hitting X, I hit the option button, which simulates the whole damn thing without playthrough. Yeah, I tried backing out of it, and unfortunately the autosave saved it. I tried reloading it from, instead of hitting continue, I hit load. It wouldn't do it, so I'm screwed. So there will be no gameplay, airplay of Greed. So I'm going to have to show you guys what happened. I'm pretty pissed off. So let's take a look at the matches. So in the first match, we had Akira Tozawa defend his title against Pete Dunne, and he successfully defended his title. In match two, Lita defended her title against Bianca and won. So that's two title matches that have been defended and successful. Match three, a tables match, the feud between Big Show and Sting. Sting won this match. How he got Big Show through a table, we'll never know, because I screwed up. Match four, I went with Velveteen Dream and Johnny Gargano. We haven't seen much of Johnny at all, but Velveteen's been pretty impressive lately. So I put him in a match at Greed, and he won the match. So Velveteen's someone to keep an eye on. In this match with the tag titles on the line, I decided to make it a tornado tag match because the contendership match that was in episode 3, I believe, of NXT, it was a draw. So rather than have them fight it out for the number one contendership again, I just said, let's just do a six-man tag and have fun with it. Undisputed and The Bar in the match against the Outsiders. Outsiders lost. It looks like Undisputed Era won, so they are new tag team champions. And then since Money in the Bank is at the end of the year, I didn't want to go the whole year without a Money in the Bank holder for any shows. So since this is Greed, I figured this would be the perfect pay-per-view to do it. So I had eight men go for the men's title belt briefcase. And of all the people in the match, Kurt Angle won the damn thing. So he is Mr. Money in the Bank for WCW. Beat Goldberg. They were the final two. And the women's Money in the Bank, Charlotte Flair won it, beating Beth Phoenix. So Charlotte Flair is Miss Money in the Bank for WCW. And in the main event, Batista won the World Heavyweight Championship against Edge, making Batista the World and U.S. Champion. Now, because of this, we're going to take a look at the championships. So you can see Batista is the top dog in both the World title and the U.S. title. Hall and Nash are... Why are they still holding the titles? That should be... That was a title match. I don't know why they're... I'm going to have to look into that. That says Nash and Hall are still the champs. That's not right. It should be the Undisputed. Tozawa is still the champ there. Lita is still the champ there. Kurt Angle holds the holder. And Charlotte Flair is the holder there. So, here's what's going to happen in the next episode. You saw my announcement in episode 3 where I said there was going to be a draft lottery on Raw. That's going to be the next episode. I've already gone through every roster and decided I'm going to do 10 names from each roster that is going to be available for the draft. The only rules are, and I'll explain this in the next episode, the only people who are exempt from this are champions or Money in the Bank holders. So any champs on Raw, SmackDown, or WCW are exempt. And that includes Money in the Bank briefcase holders. Now, I want to also point out that when I first began this playthrough, there were no Money in the Bank holders for WWE. So I changed that. I went back into the archives. I looked back in history. Who was the real winners? And it was Otis and Asuka. And so I made them the Money in the Bank holders for WWE. Well, I found out the computer simulated Asuka cashing in, and she won. So she's the new WWE Women's Champion. So Becky Lynch is now available, but Asuka is not available for the draft. So I have 10 superstars picked from each show, and I'm going to use my little spin wheel I had when I did this playthrough before I did a draft, and I had an online spin wheel I could do for names. Unfortunately, it comes in 4 different colors. I don't think I can break it up into just 3 colors. So I'm going to look into that, and if that's true and I can't break it up into 3 groups instead of 4, if I have to do 4, the 4th one will be Divas, and I'm going to pick 3 from each show, and then there'll be a 4th extra one I'll choose who I think will be available. So that'll all be explained in the next episode of Raw, but I wanted to let you guys know about that. And I also am going to add, now that we're in the month of June, as you will see here, I made that announcement that WCW 205 Live is going to be coming, and I'm going to be putting it right here. I'm going to do that off camera so you guys can't see it. I'll be doing all that. So as you can see there, Batista is the World Heavyweight Champion. Charlotte Flair won Money in the Bank match. She can cash in and challenge the current WCW Women's Champion wherever she wants. Kurt Angle, same thing. And then the rest of these are just all announcements from those shows. So, unfortunately, can't show you Greed. I was really looking forward to it, but oops. That's kind of my bad. So, next episode will be Monday Night Raw, this one right here. And then the next one for us after that will be NXT. And then 205 Live. Our next pay-per-view... next WWE pay-per-view, I believe, is... Why does that say Backlash? I thought Backlash was last month. Oh, excuse me. This is the next one year. Yeah, because we're still in right here. I got to advance forward, and I can't do that yet. Next one for WWE is Fastlane, and we have the Bash at the Beach. So it's going to be a fun month leading up towards Bash at the Beach. And so the next episode will be Raw. And then for us after that will be NXT and then 205 Live. And I will have a decision. There will be an announcement regarding Batista and if he will be allowed to continue as a dual champion or if he has to give up the U.S. title for somebody else. You guys will have to wait and see that decision on the next episode. So thank you for tuning in. And we'll see you in the next episode. If you like this episode, hit that like button. Leave a comment if you like. Subscribe to the channel. If you'd like to help out with future projects, upgrades to the channel, please visit my Patreon at patreon.com/mntwins28. Or you can drop something in the old Cash App. You don't have to help, but any help is always greatly appreciated. Until next time, peace out.